I'm TarikMerryface, and welcome to this remake of the CRP-5 Finding TAS Part 1 tutorial. As was pointed out by a commenter, I made a terribly embarrassing mistake in the first video, and I'd like to rectify it. In addition to that, I will also take this opportunity to expand a little and teach you how and when to correct for compressibility. The question I used was the following. We are given the following information, and from it, we need to find the true airspeed, or TAS. Flight level 320, temperature minus 21 degrees Celsius, CAS 240 knots, QNH 1029. What you'll see is that we won't be using all this information to find TAS. Quite often, examiners will give you too much information to see if you know how to identify and use only what you need. Notice that you would very rarely, if ever, get such a high temperature at this altitude, but we will ignore it for now for the sake of the exercise. Right, let's get our handy CRP out. The first thing to do is to identify the correct parts of the flight computer that we are going to use. Look at the two windows near the center of the wheel. There is an altitude window and an airspeed window. Unsurprisingly, we'll be using the airspeed window. The fixed scales on the top and bottom edges of the window is temperature, denoted on the right-hand side with a degree Celsius. The numbers behind the window represent pressure altitudes in thousands of feet. Therefore, we line up the given temperature with the given pressure altitude. In this case, we line up minus 21 with 32. Next, we need to find the CAS of 240 knots on the inner side of the scale. This will be denoted by 24. Line up the plastic rule and you'll find the TAS. Here, we find it to be 425 knots. Now, we encounter a problem. The airspeed has reached such a high value that the compressibility effect has most likely made the found value incorrect. Thus, we now have to correct for compressibility error. For the CRP-5, you correct for compressibility whenever the found TAS is 300 knots or above. To do this, we look at the window which is below the 60 triangle. This window is denoted by a comp core. Beneath the window, there is an arrow pointing to the left. An hour showing the current compressibility factor being used, and a small formula. TAS divided by 100 minus 3. The TAS we found was 425 knots, so we divide that by 100 to get 4.25. Next, we subtract that by 3 to end up with 1.25. This means that we will now have to turn the computer counterclockwise 1 1/4 divisions from the current compressibility correction factor. Once again, we find the CAS of 240 knots on the inner scale and read the TAS on the outer scale. We conclude that TAS equals to 411 knots. Let's summarize the method in a few bullet points. 1. Align the outside air temperature and flight level in the airspeed window. 2. Find the given CAS in the inner scale and from there find TAS in the outer scale. If TAS at this point is less than 300 knots, you have finished the question. Otherwise, continue on to step 3. Divide the found TAS by 100 and subtract 3 from it. 4. Move the wheel counterclockwise so that the compressibility factor in the comp core window moves by the amount of divisions you calculate in step 3. And step 5. Look once more at the CAS in the inner scale and find the final value of TAS in the outer scale. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. If you have any exam questions you're struggling with, feel free to post about it in the comments section, and I'll gladly make a video for it. Don't forget to check out the website, www.merryfaceaviation.com, and to subscribe to the channel. I'm Tarik Merryface, and I'll see you guys next time. Happy flying!